Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast Chart Conditional Format. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jill, and today's question sent in by Mike. Mike has, let's call it a Pareto chart. He has things that have gone wrong and the number of times each has gone wrong. And in the chart, he wants to highlight the worst offender in red and the second worst in yellow. So here I have ran between here in my chart. So every time we press F9, we get a different worst and second worst. Sometimes we even get a tie. Oh, there we go. Two items tied for red. And I've seen a tie in the yellows. There we go. Tie in the yellows. Okay, so Mike wanted to know how can I conditionally format a bar to say if it's equal to the max and another bar to say if it's equal to the second largest. Well, charts simply don't do conditional formatting, and the way that I created this is I cheated. I'm going to move the chart, and out here I built formulas. So these formulas copy the items over, and then I have columns for red, amber, and black. All right, and the red formula is saying, hey, look at B4 and see if it's equal to the largest value in B4 to B17, and I lock that down with dollar signs. If it is, then give me B4, otherwise give me 0. So in this particular data set, these values, 198 is the largest value. That's the only one that shows up in the red column. And then for the amber or yellow, to figure out the second largest value, instead of using max, I had to use the large function. So large of B4 to B17, comma 2 will give me the second largest value in this column. And so check to see if B4 is equal to the second largest value. Also, I don't want red and yellow appearing at the same time, so that would create a really tall bar that was double high. So make sure that E4 is 0. That way, in case there is a tie in the reds, like here, where this is the max and this is the second largest, so they're both showing up as red, we have no yellows in that case. And then the formula for the black column is just whatever the B4 value is minus red minus amber will give us the black. So what typically will happen is we'll have one red, one yellow, and then everything else is black. And then from there, simple matter to create a stacked column chart. So insert, column, stacked. Make sure to choose stacked. We nicely have the legend here, so I'm going to choose the series called black. Come back to the format tab, shape fill, make that be black. Choose the series called amber. Again, on the format tab, shape fill, choose yellow, and on the series called red, format, shape fill, choose red. We can now get rid of our legend there. And I also right click format data series and make the gap width narrower. That makes those columns wider. All right, so there you go. Every time we press F9 now, we'll get the largest item. So, is it really conditional formatting? No, it's not. We have to cheat. It's a horrible cheat. But people are kind of used to conditional formatting now because we can do it in the spreadsheet so much. So it's a natural question to say, hey, well, how do we do that in the chart? Well, the chart people haven't built conditional formatting in, but it's simple enough to use some formulas there in the spreadsheet to kind of make it appear as though the chart is using conditional formatting. Well, hey, I want to thank Mike for that question. I want to thank you for stopping by. Hey, for more on charts and graphs, check out the Mr. Excel Library Charts and Graphs, Microsoft Excel 2010, published by you. See you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.